Hey y'all, welcome to another WordPress Wednesday. My name is Corey Ashton. I'm excited today to kind of switch things up. Normally we do step-by-step tutorials on how to use your WordPress website. Today, I want to talk to you about what it looks like to drive traffic to your website. I want to bring you four creative ways that you might not have thought of yet of how to get people to actually come to your awesome WordPress website that we've been building, right, through all these tutorials. You've got it looking the way you love it now, but why aren't people coming there? So let's talk about that today, okay? Before I get started, I want to walk you through three of our awesome sponsors for these videos and our classes that we teach here at WebTegrity virtually and in person. If you don't know about those, check those out. I'll put the link in the description box below. WP Engine has awesome hosting for anybody dealing with WordPress websites. You need to check them out. They're a little bit on the upper scale of pricing. Doesn't matter. It's such incredible value that you get. You get a staging environment so that you can tinker and play around with your website. You get awesome support. They know WordPress. That's all they know. They love WordPress. You get extra security. So if something's going on with a plugin, they're probably going to be one of the first to alert you and lock down your website and make sure that things are okay. They also have backups in place that are a one-click restore. Amazing. So check them out. WP Elevation, if you are an entrepreneur working with WordPress, please check out their tracks that they have for you. Incredible advice on how to grow your brand. And of course, WP 101 offers awesome WordPress tutorial videos. Check them out as well. Let all three of them know that Corey Ashton sent you. I would appreciate the shout out. So let's do this, shall we? Let's figure out how to drive traffic to your website, all right? I'm gonna shrink down, even though today I really don't have a whole lot of visuals for you. So I'm gonna stay on screen so that it feels like you and I are talking, okay? The first thing I wanna walk you through how to drive traffic to your website is something that we've done in the past that has been highly, highly successful. And again, these are kind of four unconventional ways of doing things, kind of out of the box thinking, okay? So the first thing I want to suggest is doing some sort of event. So even though that's going to be an in-person or perhaps even a virtual event where you're holding something like on a GoToMeeting or a Google Hangout session, you're still going to be able to have people register for the event that will get them to your website. So you would create a form and tell everybody in your social media everywhere, hey, come to our website and register for the event, right? One of the things that we've done in the past, though, is we held an event for bloggers. We wanted them to come in and get a couple of tips on how to be better bloggers. Maybe we were talking about SEO for them. And what we did was we advertised it around and had them pay a very small fee, like $30 or $40 for an entire day. Basically, what that fee does is it covers my cost for their food for the day, as well as the venue, right? So we hold a venue. You want to keep it kind of small and intimate, maybe 30, 60, at the most 100 attendees that will cover your cost with their small fee to enter into the event. But what's happening there is people are getting to see your personality. They're getting to connect with you and realize that you're the expert in the industry. You have guest speakers come in, and all of a sudden, all these people are learning about your services. They're coming to your website to register. They're coming back to your website to hire you, and they're blasting out your website to all their friends across social media saying what a great event it was. So that is one incredible way to drive traffic to your website. Another tool that you can use if you don't really know how to get people involved in your local community is check out meetup.com. You can go there and do a search for whatever industry you're in, and there might be somebody already networking and has a whole audience of people interested in what it is you do. So it doesn't just have to be a service in our industry and be a nerd coder. You can be talking about maybe you're a service for pet grooming, right? And you're like, well, my website's all about how to groom my dog. Well, there's probably people that love to walk their dogs together, and there's a group here that you can connect with and say, hey, come meet this great person who can teach you how to train your dog to walk on a lead, right? We're thinking outside the box here and getting really creative with whatever it could be. So Meetup is a really great resource for you. All right. The second way I want to tell y'all about is using YouTube. We've already talked about this in the past. YouTube is incredible. It's the second most powerful search engine online. We don't even think of it that way, but it is. It's owned by Google, so Google loves themselves. Most of us do love ourselves. They want to see videos on your website. And the cool thing about it is they don't have to be some crazy, high-developed, you know, super professional-looking video. I would like to encourage you to not have it too shaky, to have the volume be really great, but it can be something taken from your cell phone. easily. One of the things you want to do, though, and what I want to challenge you in this is to name it correctly. So the problem is sometimes my clients will say, oh, yeah, I took your advice and I am using video for awesome reviews for our customers, right? So the customer walks in, they purchase the product, we ask them, can we take a quick video? But my clients are naming the video something like, let's say it was back at the groomers again, right? And Rebecca and her poodle. The poodle looks great, so Rebecca wants to give a great testimonial. We would take the video and we would name the video Rebecca and her poodle. Who the heck is going to Google to type in Rebecca and her poodle? You know, nobody's going to be looking for that key term. It looks nice on your channel once people already know about your YouTube video, but that doesn't help you at all with driving traffic to your website. So what I want to encourage you to do is name your videos correctly. So I'm going to show you a quick example. This one right here is a really great testimonial video from one of our clients. Move out of the way. So she's talking, it's a 24 second quick video, but I named this Responsive Web Design San Antonio Customer Review. If the screen were a little longer, you would see it fully says Customer Review. So I named it Responsive Web Design in San Antonio. That's my key term, and I'm hoping that if somebody's doing a search, this video would appear in those search results and would help people realize that we're Webtegrity and people will come to our website. Of course, we can also embed this video directly on our website, right? So be thinking about that whenever you're using videos. Speaking of social media, if we're using links and talking on our social media, I want to encourage you to always put links back to your services on your website. What you do not want to do is just all the time just write quick text, something like this. Happy Monday. We hope everyone had a safe and awesome holiday weekend. It's time to celebrate the USA and the women's soccer team did it in style, right? That's exciting, but there's no link back to my website. And if every single one of my posts on our Facebook page didn't offer the opportunity for somebody to click and come to us, we're kind of spinning our wheels and wasting our time with social media. So what I want to encourage you to do is do a post something like this. We have some great classes set for this month. Have you seen them? Google Analytics, blogging, and social media. Come get nerdy with us. Then what we're going to do is we're going to not put our .com in there. We want the actual page that they can click on and come directly to our classes listing, right? If we do that, then people can quickly get to the exact point of purchase, right? So we're going to publish that and have the picture there and all the description. So literally they can come, click there, and go immediately to our classes page, choose a class, and register. Think about that whenever you're using social media. Really, it's all about driving conversion, getting them back to your website. The fourth and final thing I want to walk y'all through, this is kind of an old idea with a new spin on it. We've heard of guest blogging before, right? The problem is, if somebody asks me, hey Corey, will you blog for my website? That means that I have to take my time, I have to optimize it for SEO, I have to write something that's relative to what they do and what I do, and it's a lot of time spent that I'm not getting paid for, right? So what if you were to do a spin on that? What if somebody were to contact me, or like Carrie does here on this example website that I'm giving you, Carrie Deals does this. She contacts really great people in the WordPress world and says, hey, can I interview you for my podcast? Here's the thing and why this works so well. She kind of puts them out there and gives them exposure on her channel. She writes everything up, right? She does the hard work. She interviews them, does all the hard work of writing up stuff, gets it out there, and then asks the person, hey, since I've highlighted you, would you blast it out on your social media? So what she's doing is she's utilizing their network as well. It makes total sense, doesn't it? So find somebody in your industry that has a great audience. Ask them if you can interview them. Take them to lunch, record it, write it down, write up a really great blog post, send them the link and say, hey, do you approve of this? Wonderful. Would you consider blasting it out to your social media and sending them to our website? Thank you so much for the time, right? It's exciting. Those are four crazy new ways that you might be able to drive traffic to your website. And of course, if you're not using Yoast, Y-O-A-S-T, the plugin for SEO, be sure to plug that in as well and start utilizing that. We have a great series that Yousef did here on our channel, four of those videos. All right, it's 10 minutes. That's it. I appreciate y'all hanging out with me. Be sure to click here. I'm going to put the subscribe button right here because next week we're going to talk about conversion. Once they're here to your website, how do we actually get them to do what we're asking them to do? See you next WordPress Wednesday. Bye, y'all.